Hi everyone, and welcome back to Creative PowerPoint. Let's make this animation inspired from the movie Catch Me If You Can in PowerPoint. Are you exploring motion graphic techniques in PowerPoint? Post your work on social media with this hashtag. And if you like this video, don't forget to leave a like, comment, and subscribe. Let's set up the background. Right-click on an empty slide and select Format Background. Select Gradient Fill and set up 3 gradient stops of the right color. Use the color chart from the example file to guide you. Let's make the gradient radial and ensure the darker blue is at the bottom right. This animated title uses the typeface Kulvetica, the funky brother of Helvetica. You can download it for free on the internet. Look for the link in the video description. Let's now add the text with the right size. To customize and animate the text, we will convert it to shapes with the fragment tool. Let's add a rectangle to cover the title. And let's send this new rectangle to the back. When we use the fragment tool, we will end up with 31 shapes. One for this part of the rectangle highlighted in orange, one for every letter, even for the dots of the eyes, and one for the counters, that is white space inside the letters. Let's try this. Select the title. With the Command or Control key selected, click on the rectangle to add it to the selection. Let's go to the Shape Format ribbon, under Merge Shapes, select Fragment. Let's remove the shapes we don't need. Let's make the stem of the letter F longer. To do so, we'll also use the Fragment tool to separate the stem from the stem arc. Let's add a rectangle on top of the stem of F, and fragment the letter. Remove the unwanted shape and resize the stem of F. Let's use the same technique to extend the stem of U. Let's repeat this step to extend the top of the stem of T. Let's also use the fragment tool to separate the ball of the letter Y from its stem and tail. Let's now remove the stem of P because we will extend the stem of U to become the stem of P. Draw a rectangle over the stem of P, remove its outline for more precision, and nudge it with your arrow keys. Select the P. Add the rectangle to the selection by holding the Command or Control key, then go to the Shape Format ribbon, under Merge Shapes, select Subtract. Let's reposition the text boxes and ensure that the stem of U extends to become the stem of P. Let's reposition our text, extend the stems to the slide borders, and color the Me. Before we animate, let's go to the selection pane and give nice names to our shapes. I've named every letter after the word it appears in, with the actual letter capitalized. I also took the opportunity to merge eyes with their dots and the two parts of the F to simplify the animation. To do so, select the parts you want to unify, go to the Shape Format tab, under Merge Shapes, select Union. Okay, we are now ready to animate. In a first phase, I propose to animate every part separately, without caring about the duration or timing. Let's start with the F. I'll add a strip right up. I'd like it to go down for the eye to have an alternating movement. Let's add a strip left down. Let's animate the ball of the Y. Let's use a strip right down. Then the stem of the Y, let's use a split horizontal out animation. Then let's animate the O, we'll use strips right up. Then the bowl of the U strips right down. Notice how I alternate between strips right up and strips right down. Then the stem of the U wipe from bottom. Then the C strips right up. The A strips right down. The N strips right up. Let's animate the top line. We'll proceed to the left, starting from the middle P. Alternate between strips left down and strips left up. For the R, it's going to be a strips left down. The E strips left up. W strips left down. O strips left up. P strips left down. Then, for the bowl of the middle P, strips right down. I want this downward movement to continue to the O, strips right down again for the O. The I strips right up. The N strips right down. T strips right up. For the top stem of the T, we'll use wipe from bottom. M strips right down. E strips right up. Then let's add a float out animation for the M and another one for the E. We can try the animation and see it letter by letter. Now let's add the correct timings. Select one of the animations in the animation pane and press Command A or Control A to select them all. Make them all start with previous and add a duration of 0.30 seconds for all of them. Now we just need to go through them one by one and set an increasing delay. The rule of thumb is start with a delay of 0.5 seconds for the first letter, add 0.2 seconds for every extra letter, and 0.1 second inside a letter. Don't forget that the animation propagates to multiple letters at the same time. You can use the example file as a reference. Our animation is complete. Let's see it.